Let us solve the 11th problem. Show that the direction cosines of a vector equally inclined to the axis OX, OY and OZ are plus or minus 1 by root 3, comma plus or minus 1 by root 3, comma plus or minus 1 by root 3. Okay. So here what we have to do is we have to show that the direction cosines of a vector which is equally inclined to the 3 axis are plus or minus this. Okay. So let us start solving the problem. Solution. So first let us consider the vector with the given condition. So let A bar be a vector which is equally inclined to the axis OX, OY and OZ. Okay. Now what we will do is we will consider the angles made by this vector to the 3 axis. So let alpha, beta and gamma be angles made by the vector A bar with the 3 axis OY, OX and OZ. Okay. Then we will get this cos alpha I cap plus cos beta j cap plus cos gamma k cap is a unit vector. Okay. In the direction of A bar. Okay. So why this we have studied this, if alpha, beta, gamma are the angles made by a vector A bar, then we can write this vector, okay, which is nothing but cos alpha I cap plus cos beta j cap plus cos gamma k cap, and this vector is in the direction of A bar. This is important, okay. And also it is a unit vector, okay. So where, what are cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma? This you have studied. Cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma are direction cosines, okay. Where cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma are direction cosines of vector A cap. Okay. Now what is given is the vector A bar is equally inclined to the 3 axis. Okay. So now alpha B is equal to beta is equal to gamma. Okay. Because A bar is equally inclined to the 3 axis OX, OY and OZ. Alright. Okay. Now we know this thing, the identity. We know that cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to 1. Right. This we have studied. So what we will get, since alpha, beta and gamma are equal, so we will get cos square alpha plus cos square alpha. So beta is equal to alpha, so we get cos square alpha here. Also gamma is equal to alpha, so we get cos square alpha equal to 1. Okay. So this implies 3 times cos square alpha is equal to 1, right? So this implies cos square alpha is equal to 1 by 3. So that means cos alpha is nothing but plus or minus root of 1 by 3. So that means cos alpha is equal to plus or minus 1 by root 3, right? So now we have to look at this. Since alpha is equal to beta is equal to gamma, what we get is cos alpha is equal to cos beta equal to cos gamma, right? Just we have to operate cos here. So this is true, right? So this implies plus or minus 1 by root 3 is equal to cos alpha, right? From here, so cos alpha is in turn equal to, we saw this, cos beta and cos gamma, right? So therefore cos alpha is plus or minus 1 by root 3, then cos beta is equal to plus or minus 1 by root 3, and also cos gamma is equal to plus or minus 1 by root 3. So therefore the direction cosines, these are direction cosines, right? So direction cosines of A bar are plus or minus 1 by root 3 plus or minus 1 by root 3 and plus or minus 1 by root 3. That is nothing but just we can take plus or minus common. If even if you stop at this, you will get full marks, okay, for answering. So but I'll write the textbook answer, which is there, 1 plus or minus 1 by root 3 comma 1 by root 3 comma 1 by root 3, okay. So that is the answer of the first problem. Now let us go to the second problem in the video, that is the 12th one. Let A bar equal to I cap plus 4 J cap plus 2 K cap, B bar equal to 3 I cap minus 2 J cap plus 7 K cap, and C bar equal to 2 I cap minus J cap plus 4 K cap. Find a vector D bar which is perpendicular to both A bar and B bar, and C bar dot product D bar is equal to 15. So these three vectors are given to us, A bar, B bar and C bar. We have to find the vector D bar which is perpendicular to both A bar and B bar, and also it satisfies this condition, C bar dot product D bar is equal to 15, okay. So let us start solving the problem. Solution: first of all, we will take this condition which is given in the problem. So we have to let the vector D bar with this condition. So let D bar be perpendicular to both A bar and B bar, and C bar dot product D bar be equal to 15, okay. Now we know that A bar cross product B bar is perpendicular to A bar and B bar, this we have already studied, okay. So we know that A bar cross product B bar is perpendicular to both A bar and B bar, okay. So if we call this as 1, okay, and this is 2. So what we have to do is now find A bar cross product B bar. So A bar cross product B bar is equal to determinant I cap J cap K cap, right? Then the coefficients of the first vector, that is 1, 4, 2, and then the coefficient of the second vector, that is 3, minus 2, 7. Okay, so this implies A bar cross product B bar is equal to, just we have to expand this determinant, I cap into 7 times 4 is 28, minus of minus 2 times 2 is plus 4, minus J cap, 7 times 1 is 7, minus 3 times 2 is 6, okay, plus K cap, minus 2 times 1 is minus 2, and minus 3 times 4 is minus 12. So this implies A bar cross product B bar is equal to 32 I cap minus J cap माइनस 14 के कैप. ओके नाउ सी फ्रॉम 1 एंड 2 व्हाट वी गेट. फ्रॉम 1 एंड 2 from 1 and 2 what we get is this D bar is perpendicular to both A bar and B bar, and also A bar cross product B bar is perpendicular to A bar and B bar. So from 1 and 2 D bar and A bar cross product B bar are perpendicular to both A bar and B bar. Okay. So if we draw the diagram here, so this is suppose A bar and this is B bar vector. So a vector which is perpendicular to this both A bar and B bar will be in this way, right? So we know that A bar, so this is perpendicular to both vectors. So if we call this as A bar cross product B bar, and D is also perpendicular to both A bar and B bar. So D can be here, okay, or D can be also in this way, downwards, okay, but perpendicular, right? But perpendicular to both A bar and B bar. So what we can conclude is D bar is equal to lambda times A bar cross product B bar. So therefore D bar is just lambda times A bar cross product B bar. Okay, so this implies D bar is equal to lambda times 32 I cap minus J cap minus 14 K cap. Okay, now also from 1 again what we get, from 1 we get C bar dot product D bar is equal to 15, right? This, so let us now take C bar, which is 2 I cap minus J cap plus 4 K cap. 2 I cap minus J cap plus 4 K cap dot product lambda times this 32 I cap minus J cap minus 14 K cap equal to 15. Okay, so this implies lambda times, so 2 I cap, because lambda is a scalar, we can take it out of the dot product. So 2 I cap minus J cap plus 4 K cap dot product 32 I cap minus J cap minus 14 K cap equal to 15. So that means lambda into, so 2 times 32 is 64, minus 1 times minus 1 is plus 1. Dot product we are taking. 4 times minus 14 is minus 56 equal to 15. Okay, so that means lambda times 64 plus 1 is 65, 65 minus 56 is 9, okay, equal to 15. So that means lambda is equal to 15 by 9. So that means lambda is equal to 5 by 3. Okay, so this is the value of lambda. So from, if we call this as 3, so from 3 we get D bar is equal to 5 by 3 32 I cap, okay, minus J cap minus 14 K cap, minus J cap minus 14 K cap. So this implies D bar is equal to 1 by 3. So 5 we can take and multiply it to this bracket. So 32 times 15, let us see what it is. 32 times 5 to the 10, 5 to the 15 plus 1 is 16. So 160 I cap minus 5 j cap, right, minus 14 times 5, 4 5s are 20, 5 1 are 5 plus 2 is 7, so 70 k cap. Okay, so this is the answer. In the textbook it is given as plus 70 k cap, but that is not correct. So this is the correct answer. So that's it in the video. If you have liked the video, please hit the like button. If you have not subscribed my channel, please do subscribe. I will see you in the next video.